Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys about the abstract keyword in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Alright, let's talk about the abstract keyword. So this is a keyword that can be applied to both classes and methods when you define them. Let's begin with abstract classes. An abstract class cannot be instantiated, but they can have a subclass that can be. And here's an example. I have two additional classes, a class called Vehicle and a class called Car that extends Vehicle. So Car is the subclass, also known as the child class of the Vehicle class, and we can create objects from both of these classes. And let's try that. So first, let's create a car. Car equals new car. And let's also create a vehicle object because we can. So vehicle equals new vehicle. So we can create instances of both of these classes just fine, but we may not want to be able to do so. So adding the abstract keyword to a class adds a layer of security. So here's an example. Let's pretend that we walk into a car dealership and we ask a salesperson for a vehicle, and they might reply with, "Well, what kind of vehicle are you looking for? Are you looking for a car, a motorcycle, a truck?" And we just say, "No, we want a plain generic vehicle." And they might think you're crazy because a vehicle is too generic. It's an idea. It's abstract. Well, at least it should be abstract. We need a certain type of vehicle. So what we could do to prevent somebody from creating an instance of a class that is too vague or abstract, we can use the abstract modifier when we declare this class. So with vehicles, let's add the abstract modifier. And we can no longer create an instance of this class, and it says cannot instantiate the type vehicle. So this adds a layer of security to this program. So in order to get this to run, we cannot declare a vehicle object. We have to pick a certain type of vehicle, a child class of the vehicle class, whether it's a car, a bike, a truck, whatever. Now we can also create an abstract method too. So let's declare this within the vehicle class. And an abstract method is declared without an implementation. So that means without a body. So let's say that all vehicles should have a method to go, because that's the point of a vehicle. So all vehicles should go. This is going to be an abstract method. We're going to use the abstract keyword. We need a return type. We'll just make this void, and this will be go. And we do not need a body for this method. And if we attempt to add a body, a set of curly braces, well, we're going to have a problem. And this says abstract methods do not specify a body. So what this does is that it forces us to implement this method in one of the child classes that our vehicle class has. So if we attempt to run this, actually you can see that it's popping up already. The type car must implement the inherited abstract method vehicle.go. So what we could do is add unimplemented methods, and what we're doing is actually method overriding. So we can add our own implementation of this go method, more specifically for cars. So let's say maybe the driver is driving the car, and that should be fine. So we can no longer create an instance of the vehicle class because it's abstract and a vehicle object is too vague. So we would like to force a user to pick a certain type of vehicle, a class that inherits from the vehicle class. And we can also use the go method that is found within the vehicle class too, but we are forced to override it or implement it in each of the child classes that our vehicle might have. And it's just the same as what we would normally do with calling a method. So car.go, and this will print the driver is driving the car. So that's the whole point of the abstract keyword. It adds a layer of security to your program, and this can be applied to both classes and methods. If it's applied to a class, a user cannot instantiate an instance of an abstract class. And with abstract methods, they are declared without an implementation, but a subclass or child class has to implement that somewhere. Well, that's the basics of the abstract keyword. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the abstract keyword in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me. help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.